Hey, anyone who happens to listen to this, which will probably only be like three people, but that's okay. Something's been stirring in my heart and in my mind for about a year, maybe a little less than a year. And I really feel like today I need to say something and express my thoughts and my concerns publicly. This is motivated by a few things. Specifically, kind of the number one thing that kind of lit a fire under me today was I've been following the Micah Miller case and hearing a lot about her husband, who's a pastor, and all the ways that he not just was threatening and most likely abusive to her, but the concrete data that we have about him and his past. And for example, the criminal charges of assault and battery that he had pled guilty to in his first marriage, things like that, and how he was kept on staff at his church, which I believe to be a Baptist church in South Carolina, in spite of all this being public knowledge. And I think that is a really, really, for lack of a better term, concerning reality that the church as a whole, the body of Christ, needs to look at and take very seriously and ask ourselves, not just this one particular church in Myrtle Beach, but ask ourselves as a whole, how have we let this happen? In my own personal experience as a therapist, working with clients who've experienced spiritual abuse, it's just become more and more apparent to me that we've got a big problem in the church. So I'm just going to read what I wrote today. I wrote, pastors have a lot of power over people. So just stop and think about that. Pastors have a lot of social power over people. They have the power to manipulate and coerce. So, number one, for individual members of the body of Christ, I want to encourage you that it is healthy and it is wise to be cautious and to be alert when you are attending church. Do not feel pressured by church leadership to dive in head first into any church community under the guise of being planted without asking and following through on your questions and taking time to observe, a good amount of time to observe the dynamics and the culture and the practices of any given church. If you sense in your gut that something seems off or feels kind of slimy, do not ignore that. Take it seriously. The tricky thing about Christianity and why the Christian community is a perfect environment for narcissists and controlling people to get away with their behavior is because it's easy to disguise it all with biblical language. I've been in the church my entire life for 40 years and in a multitude of different church communities, different denominations. So I've got experience. The Christian community is a perfect environment for narcissists and controlling people to get away with their behavior because it's so easy to disguise it all with biblical language, themes of sacrifice, giving everything to serve God and advance his kingdom, honor culture, respecting authority, talk language about not stirring up strife or division, they all get twisted in order to silence, control, and manipulate people. And it's an insidious form of spiritual abuse because it's so slippery, and because it all has a ring to it of truth. And, you know, scriptures are pulled directly from the Bible often and quoted to back up what they're saying. And so, you know, you get people who are drawn to a pulpit, to a platform, to a stage, to, you know, being public figures and having this social power. And they're often really, really slick and crafty and able to use God-breathed scripture and twist it just enough to use it to their advantage to manipulate and spiritually abuse people. So the church needs to be on alert. Individuals need to be on alert themselves and guard their hearts and practice discernment and ask good questions and follow through on those questions and not allow themselves to be silenced or gaslit. I hate the word gaslit. It's so overused, but there are times when it's appropriate. And then the church as a whole, the body of Christ as a whole, needs to pay way more attention to this and take some real concrete action to address this. I go on to write, you know what Jesus was most angry about during his time on earth? The religious leaders in the community who exploited their positions of power and authority to control, exploit, and manipulate people and to boost their own egos. In my opinion, holding pastors accountable, inviting the honest feedback of church members and taking it seriously, having boards of directors who are truly wise, objective, discerning, and willing to protect their congregations. A lot of times, church boards are just all the pastor's buddies who are loyal by default to the pastor. That is so dangerous. So having truly wise, objective, discerning board members who are willing to protect their congregations and hold their pastors accountable, absolutely essential. We need it to be drilled into pastors that because of the social power that comes with their role, they need to be somber and take very seriously the fact that they have the potential to cause a lot of damage if they aren't vigilant about keeping their motives and egos in check. So I could ramble on and on about this, but I feel like that's a good place to stop. And let's just keep praying. I love the church. I want the church to thrive. And so that's where this is coming from. I have really serious concerns. And, you know, I want God to be honored, and I want his purposes to be accomplished on earth, and I want it to be done in a way that is consistent with how he wants people to be treated, for nobody to be abused or taken advantage of. Pride and power and control and greed, those have been rampant in the world since the fall. And Satan is really, really crafty. And we need to be sober-minded and on alert and take these concerns really, really seriously and actually take action as the body of Christ to do something about it.